Ghostbuster. If you enjoyed today's video, be sure to like, subscribe for more Ghostbusters content, and of course, my Ghostbusters themed magic videos. But in this video, I'm going to be showing you how I made these really tasty marshmallow Stay Puft Pops. Okay, so to make these Stay Puft marshmallow pops, you're going to need two different sizes of marshmallows. We've got a larger one and a smaller one. You're also going to need some lolly sticks, some edible cake pens, and some edible glue, or you could use melted white chocolate. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use so two of these, one for the head, one for the body, and then you've got 12 for the arms and legs. And then down here are the ones that are going to make the hat. So you can actually get two hats out of one of each. Now to cut this, what I'm going to do is I've got this hob on, it's very hot, so be careful. And then I've got a sharp knife, a straight edge one. I'm just going to put that on there for a second, and then we're going to cut through the marshmallow. And the reason we use a knife rather than scissors is, I've done this one just to show you, is if you use scissors, you're going to end up with a really curled hat. So that's why we use the knife. Now, with the knife, you want to get it hot enough to cut through the marshmallow, but you don't want to get it so hot that it singes it. So I'll just lift that on there for a second and we'll try it out just to see if... And there you go, that has cut through nicely. It's very sticky. And we've just cut through the smaller one. This knife is incredibly hot, so like I said, be careful. These marshmallows are very sticky. Now I'll turn that hob off and I'll put that to one side. Now I've got some icing sugar laid out here, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to dab these in the icing sugar just to take away the sticky part. That was the wrong part, that's the full marshmallow, I want the hat dabbed in the icing sugar. And of course you can cut the other end off if you want to do a couple of hats. Okay, the next stage is, this time we are going to use scissors, is we're just going to trim the hat around a little bit, just to make it more of a smaller circle. I think that's about right. Again, just dab that in the icing sugar to take away some of the stickiness. Okay, so that's the hard part. The next part is really, is just down to the colouring. So if we just grab my pens, and to start with, I'm going to take one of these little bits and I'm just going to colour that blue. Now, one thing doing this is you will probably get some of the pen on your fingers. So every time you've done a piece, you want to wash your hands because this ink will transfer. And I'll just show you, if I pick up this marshmallow, you'll get bits of blue on that. And you don't want that getting on the one that's actually gonna be your Stay Puft. You just want the color in the places that it's supposed to be. So we've done that. Now I'll go and wash my hands and we'll be back in a second. Okay, so I've washed my hands, I've got that bit coloured. Now we're just going to do the design on top of the hat. So we need a red and a blue pen, and we're just going to draw the design on, so like this. No ink on my hand, so safe to turn this over. And then we're going to get our edible glue and we're just going to put a little bit of edible glue on the bottom of this and just stick that in the middle. Okay, so whilst we're waiting for that to dry, we're going to get onto the fun stuff. So we're going to take a lolly stick and then we're going to take the marshmallow, and we're going to push the lolly stick through this way, just like that. And this will be, you won't need to put any glue on this, that will be sticky enough to stick. And then what we're going to do is we're going to draw with a blue pen Stay Puft's blue bib. I don't know if they're actually called bibs for sailors. I don't know if they have a special name. I should really look that up at some point. But we're going to draw that on. Thing is to do the face. Now what I like to do is I like to draw the face on before pushing it onto the stick, because I don't want to get blue on my fingers whilst I'm actually drawing the face, because then I'll just get blue ink all over it. So what we're going to do, we're going to take our black pen and we're going to draw Stay Puft's face. And I think we'll give him a happy face. And there you go, I'm pretty happy with that. And then we're going to push that on. Now you probably will get a little bit of blue ink transfer to here, but that won't be too visible. There you go. And then all that's left really is to do the hands and then start gluing everything on. So what we're going to do is we're going to lay that like this and try and get as flat as possible. And then we're going to get some edible glue. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to put a little bit of glue there and just put that there. And we're going to do the same thing again. Except this time I'm going to put a bit of glue there and on the bottom. And then put that there. And then for his hand, what I'll do is I take the scissors and just give it a couple of little snips. And I like using the scissors for this because it kind of pushes the fingers sideways slightly. And again, a bit of glue there, a bit of glue there. Goes there, and then what we're going to do is we're going to take some more glue, spread that down the lolly stick, put a little bit of glue there, push that in, a little bit of a balancing act this, again a little bit of glue on the bottom. And then with the feet, I'll put it this way, just so you get a tiny little bit sticking out. And then that goes there. And then we have to leave this to dry before we can turn it over and do the other side. So, yeah, we'll come back to that once this is all drier. Okay, so this side is set, so what we're going to do is we are going to lean this side, and you'll need to get something to lean them against now. So, and then we're going to do the same here. And then whilst this is setting, I recommend getting a box, maybe an egg box or something, and punching some holes so that you can stand him up like this, because you'll need him to stand when we stick the hat on. And it's also a good way to display him as well. So let's just get edible glue. Some of the edible glue down the stick again. just realised I need to snip some finger holes in the hand. So I'll just find my scissors. Okay, found my scissors, so we're just going to do a couple of snips through his fingers. And then just leave him there to rest and we'll come back to him once he's set. Okay, so all that's set now. All that's left is for his hat. So what I've done, I've just got this box and I've put some holes in the top so that I can stand him up like that. And then we're going to take the hat that we did earlier. And then we're just going to take a little bit of the edible glue on there. And then put that on there and then leave that to dry, and then once it's dry it'll be done. So that is how to make the marshmallow Stay Puft Pops. As you saw, they are very easy to make. You can use white chocolate instead of the edible glue if you do not have edible glue. And also, if you're going to cut the hat with a hot knife, obviously be very, very careful with that. But I hope you liked. If you're going to make your own, I'd love to see them. So make sure you find me on Facebook and tag me in your photos. Search the Magic Ghostbuster. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. But until then, keep on busting.